Hello students, myself Ganesh B. Aglave, working as an assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchin Institute of Technology, Solapur. Now in this session of conduction, we will see the heat transfer rate equation for spherical coordinate system. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to derive equation for conduction conductive heat transfer through spherical coordinate system. In previous sessions, we have derived conductive heat transfer through plane wall and through hollow cylinder. Now third case is through sphere. So I will be drawing the sphere. This is the sphere, hollow sphere you consider, and this is the small element of the sphere, small element of the sphere which is at radius r and thickness dr. The inner radius of the sphere is ri, inner temperature is ti. Outer radius is RO, outer surface temperature is TO. This is the small element of the sphere. Now, we know the general equation. We know the general equation, that is dou square T by dou R square plus 2 by r dou t by dou r plus qg by k is equal to 1 by alpha dou t by dou r. Now here only radially heat transfer will be considered and without heat generation. Assumption is that without heat generation under steady state condition. For steady state condition, change in temperature with respect to time will be zero. Then this can be simplified to dou square T by dou R square plus 2 by R dou T by dou R is equal to zero. Now multiplying throughout by R square, we get R square dou square T by dou R square plus 2 R dou T by dou R is equal to 0. As flow is in the radial direction, instead of dou I can write D. Now R square d square T by dr square plus 2 R dt by dr is equal to 0. This equation is the differentiation of d by dr of r square dt by dr is equal to 0. Suppose this is the equation number 1. Now I can take the integration of equation number 1, then I can write dt is equal to c1 by r square into dr. If I take second integration also, then it will become t is equal to minus c1 by r plus c2. This is the equation number 2. Now in this equation we have two constants c1 and c2, so their relations are to be obtained. For that purpose I will be using the boundary conditions. So boundary conditions are: first boundary condition, at r is equal to ri t is equal to ti, and second boundary condition, at r is equal to ro t becomes equal to to, because there are two two boundary conditions are there and there two temperatures are there. So using first boundary condition, equation 2 can be written as Ti is equal to minus C1 R I plus C2, and using second boundary condition it will become To is equal to minus C1 by RO plus C2. I can subtract the equation 4, this equation 4 from third equation, then I can write Ti minus To is equal to minus C1 in the bracket 1 by RI plus 1 by RO, C2 C2 will get cancelled. So Ti minus To, I can divide it by, I will simplify further, minus C1 in the bracket 1 relation will become equal to Ti minus To divided by 1 by RO minus 1 by RI. This is the constant C1. Now we will move ahead for finding the constant C2. For constant C2, what I will do? I will substitute C1 in equation number 3. So Ti in equation 3 I will be substituting. So Ti is equal to minus Ti minus To by 1 by RO minus 1 by RI. This is a constant C1 multiply by 1 by RI plus C2. Further, C2 can be written as Ti minus minus plus Ti minus To by 1 by RO minus 1 by RI into 1 by RI. So this is the constant C2. Substituting constant C1 and C2 in equation number 2 now. In this equation, we have to substitute constant C1 and C2. So T will become minus C1 is Ti minus To by 1 by RO minus 1 by RI. This is the C1 multiply by 1 by R, and plus C2 is plus Ti plus Ti minus To by 1 by RO plus minus 1 by RI into 1 by RI. This Ti I will take on the left hand side, so T minus Ti will be there, is equal to Ti minus To divided by 1 by RO minus 1 by RI can be taken common, inside the bracket it will be 1 by RI minus 1 by R. So T minus Ti divided by Ti minus To will become equal to this Ri RO will go in the numerator divided by Ri minus RO in the bracket 1 by Ri minus 1 by R. So this is the temperature distribution equation. This becomes temperature distribution equation, first part. Now we'll move to the second part. Rate of heat conduction. We'll move to the second part, that is rate of heat conduction. you have rate of heat conduction, as we know. Fourier's law of heat conduction we know, that is minus Ka dT by dr, dT by dr. So here we will be substituting the T, and T was equal to minus C1 by R plus C2. Here C1 and C2 are to be substituted, that we will do here. So which is equal to minus Ka d by dr of t, that is Ti minus To by 1 by Ro minus 1 by Ri minus 1 by Ri into 1 by R plus C2. So C2 was equal to Ti plus Ti minus To by 1 by Ro minus 1 by Ri into 1 by Ri. If we differentiate, this will get cancelled. This will also get cancelled because all are the constants are there. So I can write minus Ka. Now taking the differentiation of R, that will be minus 1 by R square in other bracket Ti minus To by Ri minus Ro divided by Ri into Ro, and here the area, so this minus minus will become plus K 4 pi R square. This will be 4 pi R square into 1 by R square into Ti minus To divided by Ri minus Ro into Ri into Ro. So this R square will get cancelled. I can write directly Q is equal to 4 pi Ri Ro 4 pi Ri Ro K into Ti minus To divided by Ri minus Ro. Here this can be written in terms of the thermal resistance, Ti minus To divided by Ri minus Ro by 4 pi Ri Ro K. This is nothing but thermal resistance, and here we have derived the rate of heat conduction. For further study, you can refer Fundamentals of Heat and Mass Transfer by Inkropera David. Thank you.